It's just started.
Ooh, I know.
It's like, it's a lot. There's a lot of pressure around this show, and
it's such
a meaningful show.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, some people could interpret it as pressure, but to me, it's one of the most meaningful things that I've ever done. I have a very limited exposure to military anything, period. And when I first got cast in this, I almost had no idea what I was getting myself into. But the very first day that I landed in Fort Hood, Texas, I realized like the impact that this is going to have on a lot of people. I mean, so many of the vets came out to give us their blessing before we shot this thing. They had built 200 buildings for us to destroy, like to simulate Solder City, to a point where they had the vets coming through the town and just making sure everything was accurate. And it just means so much as an actor, as an artist, to be able to tell a story that means so much to this many people. And to see it behind their eyes when they thank me and say thank you for being a part of this. It's one of the most deep, meaningful things that I've ever experienced.
What was it like preparing for this role? Because there's a lot, like what you just said, it's so meaningful and so powerful to so many people.
Yeah.
What was it like for your preparation process?
My preparation process to begin with, even before I even got to Fort Hood, was obviously reading Martha Raddatz's book just to know what happened and what was the context of us going in. And then after that was when we landed and we started doing our 2 weeks of boot camp training with the Army Rangers. Oh yeah, it's a lot. But the Army Rangers are very nice to us, which is even scarier than if they were yelling at us, because that's what I was expecting. and then at that point, I filled my head with all the facts, and it was when I landed here and started talking to the vets themselves that everything got shoved from here straight into here. And there's a lot of stories of, like, we had a reunion the first week that we were on base with all the vets who came by, and I'm the only Asian soldier in this platoon, and spoiler alert, Eddie Chen dies, and I'm the only Asian guy there, right? So then as soon as some of these vets see me, they would have to hide their eyes. They would just have to go, sorry, give me a second, I need to. And then they would say, okay, hi, it's good to meet you, you're playing Eddie, huh? And yeah, and it was, I could only take about like 45 minutes of that before I was like, I'm overloading, like, but it's, yeah, like there's just a lot of tears being shed and a lot of very buried emotions for a lot of these guys who haven't shared any of this with their parents, their family, their kids, and then they would come up to me and say thank you. Now they know why I am the way that I am.
That's so beautiful. That must be an incredible feeling for you as an actor to be able to tell something that's so meaningful to so many people, and to you, that you'll walk away with a better experience.
Absolutely. I actually made this at home, this recipe, Sergeant Chen, because it meant such, this is a very deep experience for me, and it's something that I'll take with me for the rest of my life.
Well, I know we're all excited to see it, so congratulations.
Thank you, I really appreciate
that. Best of luck with everything.
Thank you so much.